Hello guys, welcome yourselves back into MF93. We are playing MotoGP 21. Okay, remote, kita dah kat Moto2. Race keempat in Jerez, ataupun orang Melayu panggil Jerez. Okay, championship kita nombor 3 selepas kita menang di Portimao. Tapi aku tak confident di Jerez. FP1, FP2 dry, nombor 2 dengan nombor 7, okay lah. Tapi FP3 dah start hujan, kita P21. So qualifying ni tak confident langsung.
Here we are, back at the track, waiting for the second qualifying session to start. 18 riders classified, but only one will start from pole position in tomorrow's race.
Okay, kita straight into qualifying 2. Masa FP3 lepas berround-round kat track ni dalam hujan, memang tak confident langsung. Licin dia lain daripada Portimao. Aku tak tahu kenapa.
Just a few last touch-ups to his suit and helmet and he's ready to go. We've noticed that the mechanics have been really active in the last few minutes. Let's see if they'll make the difference on the track.
Memang tak ada grip langsung. Tak tahu lah, maybe motor tak habis upgrade lagi. So memang macam orang kata like riding on ice lah. Gila punya licin. Itu yang FP3 memang paling terbaik dapat pun P21 daripada 31 motor. Tapi sebab FP1, FP2 dry, so quite good timing. Tak payah lalu Q1 lah, so direct Q2. So kita tengok qualifying paling tinggi berapa boleh dapat. Okay, lepas dah habis berapa? P16 or 15 tadi aku tengok. Marcel Schroeter pole, Cameron Bobby. Ah, tak tahu macam mana sebut. Second. Kita nombor 16 daripada 18 rider Q2.
Hello and welcome to the Jerez de la Frontera circuit. Just a few more minutes before the Moto2 race at the Spanish Grand Prix finally begins. After the rain a few hours ago, the skies have finally cleared up. But there hasn't been enough time between the rainfall and the start of the race to let the track dry out. This means that the race has been declared wet, leaving the choice of most suitable tyres to each individual rider. We are now coming from the starting grid, where everything seems ready. It's always difficult to predict the results of the Moto2 race, but the riders we're seeing right now definitely seem to be the favourites.
Okay, itu dia Schroeter pole position, Bobier, second place. Third, tadi tak ingat siapa, Aaron Canet kot. Tak apa, tengok sekejap lagi. Tukar disc depan, dia suruh ambil yang kecil sikit, so hitting time tak lama. Oh kan, VAT, third place. Aaron Canet, fourth. Joe Roberts, fifth. Jimmy Gardner, nombor 6. DG, nombor 12. So sekarang ni kita punya championship rival is Remy Gardner dan Fabio Di Giannantonio, ataupun nama pendek dia DG. Okay, tengok warm up lap.
Just a few moments to go until the start of the Spanish Grand Prix. These riders know it will be vitally important to take the first curve perfectly.
Let's go! Biasa-biasa je start. Still in P16. Into the first corner. Okay, someone crash. Oh.
Okay,
terlanggar Augusto Fernandez sikit. Follow belakang Ben Schneider and Raul Fernandez. Straight into P14, drop back to P15. Keluar turn 5 into the long straight. Okay, kita P10 now after that corner. Di belakang Lorenzo Baldassari. Okay, sebab race ni memang tak ada grip langsung. So sebab Remy Gunner kat nombor 8 tu, DG kat belakang, kita dah wide ni, so DG potong je. Macam betul. Okay, asalkan kita finish somewhere dekat-dekat dengan Gunner and DG, okay tu. Tengok, baru first lap dah jauh dia orang, top 10. Sedikit wide to the final corner. Okay, minyak dah negatif sebab kita pakai power mapping 3 lama sangat tadi. Tak stable under braking. Marco Bezzecchi sudah mula main kasar. Itu turn 4. Entahlah, lain macam licin dia. Season lepas Moto3 hujan juga, tapi tak macam ni. Moto3 aku habis race ni nombor 4 tak silap. Ini nak masuk top 10 pun struggle. Okay, corner nombor 6 dinamakan sempena Danny Pedrosa, Honda team rider. Dah retire lah, dah tak race lah. Sekarang jadi test rider tak silap. Tapi ada kabar angin mengatakan beliau ingin kembali ke MotoGP. Maybe bersama Aprilia, tak tahu. Andrea Dovizioso pun dengar-dengar cerita nak panggil balik race dengan Aprilia. Sebab sekarang dia test rider Aprilia. Tapi gosip terbaru siapa ni rider Aprilia sekarang, Alex Espargaro, dengar-dengar cerita macam tak suka Dobby masuk tim dia sebab dia nak orang yang muda-muda yang kompetitif, tak nak yang dah tu. Lebih kurang macam tu lah, tak, not that exact words lah. Okay, Bezzecchi potong kita balik. Kita potong dia balik. Dan dia jatuh. Okay, takpe, kita tengok replay. Nanti dah habis race. Tapi aku buat hal aku je tadi kat corner tu. Dia yang wide, dia langgar, dia jatuh. Okay, so stewards will investigate after the race. Now Tony Arbolino di belakang diikuti Jake Dixon. Fastest lap is Marcel Schroeter, 1:52.5. Kita 1:53.3. Jauh juga. Keluar corner je will spin. And then kita dapat track limit warning. Okay, break into the final corner yang dinamakan sempena MotoGP World Champion Jorge Lorenzo, number 99. Commentator season ni banyak compare Quartararo dengan Lorenzo. Dia jenis yang kalau dia dah dapat leading, memang aku tak dapat kejar. Commentator lah cakap. Aku ulang balik je, tapi ada betulnya juga. Patutnya Quartararo dua race lagi dia dapat menang season ni. Satu race yang tangan diinjek tu kat track ni lah, kat Jerez lah. Tangan arm pump tak berfungsi, so dia tak boleh tekan brake kuat sangat. Lagi satu dekat mana, lagi satu dekat Catalunya, dia punya racing suit terbuka. Mula-mula tak dapat penalti. Lepas race ada, tak silap aku Juan Mei kot report, dapat lagi penalti. KTM pun tiba-tiba laju. Miguel Oliveira, Mark Marquez menang dekat Saxon Ring selepas tahun tak menang race. Yelah, sebab tahun lepas dia injured. Gila lah Mark Marquez. Siapa, Honda punya team principal kata dia race menggunakan sebelah tangan sebab tangan dia yang injek tu tak 100% lagi. Sorry banyak cerita benda lain sebab daripada tadi aku nombor 11 je. Sementara tu Raul Fernandez dah follow rapat belakang, teammate kepada Remy Gardner. Last race hari tu sebelum summer break, Fernandez dah menang dekat mana, tak ingat, dekat Essen. Power gak, oh, dia dah drop awal-awal race tu, dia drop ke berapa belas dah. Lepas tu senang dia potong satu-satu, dia tiba-tiba terus leading, dah menang macam tu. Meanwhile kita almost 7 saat di belakang leader of the race, Marcel Schroeter. Raul Fernandez mencuba lagi. Terpedih tau. Nombor 1, 2, 3 tak berubah daripada nombor daripada lap first tadi. Schroeter, Cameron Beaver, tak tahu nak sebut, dengan VAT. Okay, nombor 10 DG is 3 seconds in front. Kita dah final lap. Oh, speed. Okay, break depan panas. Itu dia Jack Dixon memotong, merampas P11 daripada kita. Tak peduli, aku akan ambil balik juga. Oi, terlanggar. Okay, dua-dua rider saling mencarut satu sama lain. Kita akan potong Jack Dixon di straight line ni. Heartbreaking into turn 6 Danny Pedrosa. Jack Gleason menambahkan dirinya kembali into turn 7. Into turn 8. Okay, Gleason masih follow rapat belakang. Into turn 9, Angel Nieto. Okay, rasanya kita dah apa confirm dapat P11. Only 2 corners to go. Okay, final corner. Spin lagi. And P11 je terbaik dapat dilakukan.
The stars of this exciting race are finishing their final lap. Let's take advantage of these moments to take a look at the Moto2 final ranking.
Okay, Schroeter P1, Cameron P2, VAT P3. Macam tak berubah lah. Top 1 sampai top 6. Maybe sama kot. Okay, luckily Gardner dengan DG finish directly in front of us. So damage tak besar sangat lah. Tengok replay sikit. Ni masa lap 2 tadi ada big crash kat belakang, tengok. Terbang motor. Okay, ni insiden dengan Black Jackie. Ha, tengok kan, aku tak masuk line dia. Dia yang buat. So dia jatuh pada muka. Kita tengok Bezaki punya onboard. Okay, stewards kata racing incident. Okay, kita tengok final lap. Haa, ni tadi nak gugur jantung. Masih baik tak crash. Okay, animation apa water spray tu nampak macam dah fix lah masa motor 3 dulu buruk main. Oh, ni yang terlanggar tadi yang gamuk diorang. Marah. Apa buruk no bunyi. Ini corner Danny Pedrosa. Okay, bump sikit Jack Gleason ni. Rim belakang kena tukar warna putih balik lah. Tak menyerlah warna hitam. Okay, kita tengok onboard view untuk final corner. Habis P11. Okay, championship standing maintain 1-2-3. Tapi kita semakin jauh lah dengan Gardner. 19 point. Kita tengok Afsharin maintain maintain nombor 31. DG nombor 2 dengan 55 points. Team championship kita drop 2 anak tangga. Okay, ni memang tak dapat apa. Tapi tak apa, kontrak masih secure. Gaji pun 300 je minggu ni. Beberapa practice session tak pas. Let's see, ada ada kategori Moto3, Acosta leading, Antonelli 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 tak berubah. MotoGP masih lagi Quartararo 23 points in front of Johan Zarco. Sama macam real life, Zarco and Quartararo 1 dengan 2. Mark Marquez nombor 10, Rossi in 19th, tak ada sebarang point lagi. Okay, next race di Le Mans. Tolong tak hujan, tolong. Okay, saya baik dry. Panas terik sepanjang minggu di France. Thank you. Okay guys, that's it. Thanks for watching. Kindly like, subscribe if you have not. Please comment. Okay, good night. Bye-bye. Thank you.